In the midst of the current COVID-19 outbreak, there has been plenty of chatter about historical pandemics like the Black Plague, the 1918 Spanish flu outbreak, and one from our recent memory, the H1N1 swine flu pandemic.
Hello everyone, I'm Lakshagar from class 10th of Delhi International School.
And I am Nishit Jain of class 10th from Delhi International School.
The 2009 H1N1 pandemic was an influenza pandemic that lasted for about 19 months. That is from January 2009 to August 2010. It was a type of swine influenza that came from a strain which lived in pigs. And the first outbreak was identified in Mexico City on 18th March 2020. But the health officials reported that it has infected people as earlier as January in 2009 in Mexico City.
H1N1 swine flu is an acute disease. The known inoculation of H1N1 flu ranges from 1 to 4 days. The symptoms of H1N1 flu are similar to other influenzas, and they may include fever, cough, headache, sore throat, and muscle pain.
Swine influenza virus is transmitted to humans via contact with infected pigs or environment contaminated with swine influenza viruses people by exposure to infected droplets expelled by coughing or sneezing that can be inhaled by another person.
The best known prevention method against the swine flu was getting the H1N1 swine flu vaccine.
In September 2009, the Food and Drug Administration permitted the new swine flu vaccine, and the H1N1 vaccine was only for use in adults and children who are at least 6 months old.
By 19 November 2009, vaccine had been administered in over 16 countries.
The H1N1 outbreak led to numerous precautionary school closures in some areas. But in some areas, rather than closing school, CDC recommended that the student or the school worker with flu symptoms should stay at home for 7 days.
He was also urged schools to suspend rules such as penalties for late papers or missed classes or requirements for a doctor's note, and U.S. also enforced children for self-isolation.
During the height of fear of pandemic, some countries initiated or threatened to initiate quarantines of foreign visitors suspected of having or being in contact with others who may have been infected with the flu, but no lockdown was imposed in any country.
U.S. airlines had no major changes as of the beginning of June 2009, but continued practices for looking passengers with symptoms of flu or other infections, and aircrafts were also sanitized on daily basis.
Medical with English or Hindi?
As you wish. You can ask either in English or Hindi. There is no problem at all.
Okay, so I will continue in English.
Okay.
Are you aware of H1N1 virus?
Not so much.
Okay. How did it affect your life? If you have...
Because I am not much aware about the H1N1 virus. So I can't say more about that, but I can say that I'm not more affected from this particular this virus.
Can you please tell us that which pandemic affected you the most, COVID-19 or H1N1 virus?
COVID-19 affected me more as compared to the H1N1 virus, because of obvious reasons, as COVID-19 is going on with the community spread in our nation, and H1N1 virus is not that effective in our life. So COVID.